So dear children, I have made this flowchart for you. See this, we have learnt all these things in previous week, like sources of history, from where we are learning history, archaeological sources and literary sources. In archaeological sources, there are artifacts like pots, jewelry, statues, tools, etc. Then monuments like temples, forts, palaces, etc. Then coins, and study of coins is known as numismatics. Inscriptions and edicts like cave walls, walls of forts, palaces, temples, clay tablets, etc. In literary sources, we can see religious literature that we will learn today. Secular literature, biographies, chronicles, and travelers' account. So this part we have finished. Now we will learn this part. So we have to read about religious literature. First heading of literary sources. Literary sources means written sources, which are written in the form of books or in the form of biographies or in the form of travelers' account or chronicles, etc. So first topic is religious literature in literary sources. So let's start. Yes, now see literary sources. So literary sources includes all kinds of literature, long and short, written or oral. It can be written or oral also, like in the form of songs, in the form of bhajan and all. These are called literary sources.